This week on Christian World News, Muslim refugees are heading to America. Are they immigrants in need of shelter or invaders to be kept out? We'll show you both sides of the story.
Plus, most Americans believe in religious liberty, but do they believe it for everyone? The answer may shock you.
And greeting Gizmo. Parents and children in India find salvation through Superbook. Hello, everyone. Welcome to this week's edition of Christian World News. I'm George Thomas.
Our first show of the new year.
Yes.
Welcome, everyone. I'm Wendy Griffith. Well, it's a growing dilemma for the West. Should we allow Syrian refugees into our countries?
Yeah, very, very important question. Here in the United States, President Obama wants to bring in more refugees. But that move has met with serious opposition because of the concerns that America could be importing terrorism. My colleague Dale Hood has this look at the debate over Islam and immigration.
As Europe's winter closes in on Syrian refugees, many find themselves out in the cold.
The weather is cold. Please help.
As America prepares to accept some of them, many are asking, which of them are true refugees? What is America's role, if any, in helping them? And how many of them are ISIS?
So I take ISIS at its word when it says we want to exploit the refugee program to infiltrate the West.
President Obama says Syrian refugees are less dangerous than tourists, and he wants to bring in at least 10,000 in 2016. But warning signs abound. The Germans say almost one out of three migrants are lying about being Syrian. Czech president has warned that Europe is facing an organized invasion and not the spontaneous movement of refugees. One young refugee told this Swiss newspaper he met many radical Muslims on his way to Europe. And FBI Director James Comey has warned Congress that Syrian refugees cannot be properly vetted.
It's not just those who come in here who specifically intend to be part of plots to kill Americans. It's also those who may be most easily recruitable in the years to come.
Clifford May, president of the Foundation for Defense of Democracies, says it would only take a few terrorists to get through.
There were only a handful of people involved in the 9/11 attacks.
Just a handful. Is that okay? Are we willing to have a 9/11 attack every 1 year, every 3 years, every 5 years?
Presidential candidate Donald Trump has called for a temporary ban on all Muslim immigration. But when you actually crunch the numbers, those who have gone through the actual refugee vetting process have so far committed no acts of terrorism on American soil.
There have been no refugees admitted since 9/11 who have committed a terrorist attack in the United States.
Immigration policy analyst Alex Nalrasta says Syrian refugees in America would not come through Europe, but from camps in the Middle East. And very few would-be terrorists could make it through the refugee process.
The first level of checks to the refugee system is done by the UN, where they reject 99% of applicants. There are an additional 21 different steps undertaken by the U.S. government that a refugee must go through in order to come to the United States. For a Syrian, that takes about 3 years to go through to come here. So it's a very safe system. It is the hardest way to come to the United States.
There are easier ways for a terrorist to enter the U.S., like green card fraud or a student visa, or simply walking across the border. But what this debate seems to really be about is the religion of the refugees, Islam, and if Islam makes them a potential danger. President Obama, who continues to have trouble saying the words Muslim terrorism, seems to view Islam as the same as other religions. But many former Muslims disagree.
Is it? Is it the same as other religions?
No, it's not. Islam is different than other religions because Islam does not accept any law besides Allah's law.
We asked Brother Rashid, a former Muslim who now hosts a popular Arabic TV program called Daring Questions, if some Muslim migrants are coming to the West not as guests, but as conquerors.
Of course. I have family members in Europe and they think the same thing. I visited them and they think that they hate Europe, they hate the West, they hate their way of life, so they are there to change them.
Brother Rashid says he does not believe, as some do, that every Muslim is a potential terrorist, because he says many Muslims are not serious about their faith. But he warns that all a Muslim needs to do, like the San Bernardino bomber, is suddenly decide to follow the Quran completely. He says that is precisely what ISIS has tried to do.
These guys are devout Muslims. They are not just a bunch of terrorists who did not understand Islam. All these guys understood Islam, studied it. Al-Baghdadi, the head of ISIS, is a PhD holder in Islamic studies. So he must understand Islam to get a PhD.
There are more concerns about Muslim refugees. Polls show most Muslim countries are overwhelmingly anti-Semitic. One survey found that almost 80% of Syrians support the Palestinian terror group Hamas. Polls show most Americans overwhelmingly oppose accepting Syrian refugees, and over 30 states have refused to accept them. America is not only a land of immigrants, it is the most charitable nation on earth. But when it comes to allowing in some Muslim refugees, Americans may be forced to choose between charity and safety.
And CBN News senior reporter Dale Hurd joins us now. Dale, how do you walk that fine line between showing compassion for these refugees, but then keeping people safe in their countries?
And perhaps as a Christian, differentiating between maybe a ministry God is leading you into with refugees, but also the duties of a nation. God instituted nations, he instituted borders. There's no indication we're supposed to throw open our borders to people who could be potentially dangerous, especially when we know that ISIS is sending people here to kill us.
Well, what about the vetting process? You know, we saw how easy it was for one of the San Bernardino shooters to get in here on the fiancé visa. What needs to be done that's not being done?
Well, first, there's refugees and there are refugees. Official, strictly defined refugees, as we mentioned in the piece, go through a very strict process. It's very hard to go through. It takes many years. But people come other ways, including just across the border, and they're really not vetted at all. We find in the news just today that they've nabbed a couple of people with terrorist ties who came as refugees.
Dale, what about Germany and Sweden? They're taking a harder line with migrants. Why?
Political pressure, because, and I predicted this 10 years ago, this idea of Eurabia, Europeans on the street, natives will not stand for it. And there's going to be a turn. They're not going to allow their nations to be taken over by violence and by this alien culture.
And there are Christian refugees, right? Although many more Muslims.
Very few Christian refugees. And we need to pray for them if they're in some of these refugee camps, because it's very dangerous for them.
All right. Dale Hurd's very interesting story. Thanks so much.
Thank you.
George?
We're asking our viewers to let us know who they are and what they think about this topic. On our Facebook page, we've posted the question, should America let Syrian refugees into the country? We're asking you to share your opinion. And while you're there, let us know which country you are watching, CWN. Okay, up next, refugees are flocking to America, and one group is making sure they find a home. Watch them reunite families from around the world.
Hello, I'm Terry Newsom. Did you know there are more than 148 million orphans in the world today? 148 million. But it was three little girls that taught me about the plight of orphans. 8 years ago, my husband and I spent nearly a month immersed in the daily activities of a Ukrainian orphanage as we waited to adopt three sisters. I saw firsthand the utter loneliness, the pain of rejection, and the overwhelming desire to be loved. That experience changed me forever. And out of it grew a ministry from my heart called Orphans Promise. Today, we're helping orphans and vulnerable children in more than 50 countries worldwide. Thousands of children are now in safe homes. They're being educated, and they're learning life skills. I'm asking you to join with me and become family to these children. Will you call the number on your screen right now? Because every child deserves a chance to be happy.
Inside every child is a hero, a leader, a friend to others, someone who helps out, who does the right thing, who dreams of what they can be, but they still need our help.
What should I do?
What should I say?
How should I feel?
That's where Superbook comes in. It provides moral and spiritual truths through situations children can relate to, teaching God's word to the children you love. Join the Superbook DVD Club and receive Superbook's newest episodes as they're available, plus two copies to share with others, all for your gift of only $25. Get Superbook today and watch the miracles happen.
Welcome back. 2,000 Syrians have been accepted in the United States since the refugee crisis began after going through the government's vetting process.
One Christian group is working with these refugees to make sure they adjust to their new life here. Our Abigail Robertson shows us the successful transition for one Syrian family here in their new country.
They've escaped war zones, survived refugee camps, and just arrived in the United States to start a new life. Now, Middle East refugees face a new list of challenges. Where will they live? How will they pay the bills? Where do they learn English? And how do they enroll their children in school? Daunting questions that some Christian groups are helping the refugees answer.
This is work that is very significant, and it's a need in our world right now, and it's something we can actively do.
It is amazing what can be done when people come together, and what better way to make a refugee family feel at home in America than by welcoming them with a furnished apartment with food already in their fridge. That is exactly what churches throughout the nation are accomplishing by coming together, serving people, and showing them the love of Christ.
Church World Services works with churches around the country to help refugees from the moment they arrive at the airport.
And when we know that they're gonna come, we'll get an email, we'll get an arrival notice, and that's when we're gonna start hitting the ground running.
First step, finding a house for the family to rent, then stocking it with necessities like furniture, food, and toiletries. Next, CWS pairs each new family with a church partner. Fortunately, they currently have a list of churches waiting to sponsor families from all countries and religious backgrounds.
A welcome team is usually a church group, but sometimes small groups, very intentional groups of people who come together and say, we're going to work with a family. It adds this holistic element of community.
CWS's end goal is simple: teach each incoming family how to be self-sufficient in America. That process happens through three programs: resettlement, employment counseling, and immigration legal services. They work closely for up to 5 years with each family as they acclimate to their new society.
It's just very, very, very encouraging to watch families reach milestones.
Farhan, a Syrian, arrived with his family 5 months ago. Their journey here began in 2011, when the UN approached them about resettlement in the US. Then came 4 years of vetting overseas until they received clearance to come to America, where they found an unexpected and loving welcome.
We had a misconception about the people here, but that all changed.
Thanks to CWS, Farhan becomes more comfortable every day. His English is improving, he's working, and his daughter made it to the top of her high school class.
Before being granted refugee status, many families wait an average of 3 years as they get health and security clearances. For many of them, that time is spent inside refugee camps or hiding in the shadows of other Middle Eastern countries already overwhelmed by the refugee exodus.
While Farhan's family awaited resettlement, one of his sons turned 18 and, as a legal adult, was separated from his family's case.
He's in Jordan alone. No one is there to support him. He's not allowed to work in Jordan. His situation is very dire.
CWS tries to bring families back together, but it's not an easy legal process.
In our office, we're able to apply for family reunification, reuniting family members who have faced that sort of separation. They have to go through the same exact background check process as with refugees who are arriving without family members already here. So on average, that still takes 3 years.
Christine told us one lonely mom's story.
We had a recently arrived woman who came to Lancaster, and we did not know that she was separated from her husband and children. This mother was just recently reunited with her 16-year-old daughter, and she had not seen her 16-year-old daughter in person for 6 years. Being able to offer a space where families can be reunited after being separated for so long is extraordinary. I have no words for it.
Christine sees the perseverance of these refugees as a positive and asks Christians to pray for them through their entire journey.
These families are very resilient, survivors in a lot of ways, and not in any way helpless.
Farhan wants Americans to know that with a little help in the beginning, Syrian refugees can adjust just fine.
My call to the American people is like, we need help in the beginning. And then we will stand on our feet and do our part and work. And we want to work so we can be better and better.
And CBN reporter Abigail Robertson joins us now from our Washington, D.C. bureau. Abigail, you just recently got back from the Middle East and Europe meeting Syrian refugees. I'm curious, how many of them would rather go back home than come to the United States?
Well, I think it just matters on which refugees you're talking to. The ones who have already paid to make the difficult journey to Europe, they want to stay there. They have no plans on returning to Syria. But the ones who've kind of stayed in refugee camps in Jordan, in Lebanon, they just want to go back to their homes, their home country, and their families, and really hope that they can go back as soon as the conflict is over.
Churches in the United States see the refugees coming here as an opportunity to introduce them to the gospel. Tell us about that.
Well, as you can see by what Church World Services is doing, there are a lot of churches around the country stepping up and seeing this as the huge ministry opportunity that it is. And they're really, but from the moment they arrive in the United States, they're just loving on these people who've already been through so much. And they're not forcibly trying to convert them, but, you know, they're just being great examples of, you know, how Christ wants us to love people and opening the door to conversations about the gospel with people who maybe have never met a Christian in their life.
What's the responsibility as followers of Christ? Does it mean that we should help even those who want to harm us?
Well, this might not be a very popular answer, but I really believe it does. I think, you know, God loves every person in this world, and I think He calls us to love even our enemies. And I really believe that God can change the hearts of even these horrific people who are members of ISIS. And I think if we show them love and show them something that they don't expect and kind of just break down their preconceived notions of what Christians and Americans are like, I think God can change their heart, and we need to love all the people coming in.
Okay, and I know that churches here in the U.S. obviously see that as an opportunity to share the gospel with them. Abigail Robertson, thank you so much for this story.
Thank you.
Wendy?
Great report. Well, as we said before, tell us who you are and what you think on our CWN Facebook page. Find the post with this question: should America let Syrian refugees into the country? Give your thoughts, and while you're there, let us know from which country you are watching Christian World News. Can't wait to hear from you. Well, up next, religious liberty in America. It's not just for Christians.
You can fill your days with the life-changing power of God's Word.
Be strong and of good courage. Do not be afraid. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear.
The transforming Word, verses to overcome fear and experience peace. Available now.
Hello, I'm Terry Newsom. Did you know there are more than 148 million orphans in the world today? 148 million. But it was three little girls that taught me about the plight of orphans. 8 years ago, my husband and I spent nearly a month immersed in the daily activities of a Ukrainian orphanage as we waited to adopt three sisters. I saw firsthand the utter loneliness, the pain of rejection, and the overwhelming desire to be loved. That experience changed me forever. And out of it grew a ministry from my heart called Orphans Promise. Today, we're helping orphans and vulnerable children in more than 50 countries worldwide. Thousands of children are now in safe homes. They're being educated, and they're learning life skills. I'm asking you to join with me and become family to these children. Will you call the number on your screen right now? Because every child deserves a chance to be happy.
kids. We want them to grow up knowing God's Word. But in today's busy world, sometimes we could use some help. The free Superbook Kids Bible app has fun stuff your kids will love. They'll have a blast learning the Bible, playing great games, watching cool videos, discovering heroes in the Bible. They'll have fun while they learn God's Word. The Superbook Kids Bible app, available on iTunes and the Google Play Store.
An Irish preacher who was charged with hate speech against Muslims has been acquitted. A judge ruled that a sermon he gave in 2014 had not been sufficiently offensive to convict him. Pastor James McConnell said he hadn't intended to offend Muslims when describing their faith as satanic and many Muslims as terrorists. A Muslim scholar defended McConnell, saying freedom of speech for Christians and Muslims to disagree was on trial.
Americans place a higher priority in protecting the religious freedoms of Christians than other faith groups. In a new Associated Press poll, most people said it was very important to uphold religious freedom in general, but numbers vary dramatically when asked about specific faith groups like Muslims. 82% said religious liberty protections were important for Christians, compared with 61% for Muslims and 67% for Mormons.
CBN's Lori Johnson spoke with Ed Stetzer of Lifeway Research about this trend. He says the best way to protect religious liberty for individuals is to protect it for everyone. Take a look.
Ed, were you surprised by this study? And why do you think so many said they do not support religious freedom for people who are non-Christians?
75% of Americans say they're Christians, so they think religious liberty is good for them. But what we also have to recognize is that what's religious liberty for some ultimately becomes religious liberty for none. We need religious liberty to be a universal principle across the United States.
Well, you mentioned Islam. Now, what if a Muslim says his religious freedom means the right to follow Sharia law? How do we sift that out?
I would say that there are places where these religious liberties conflict, and if a Muslim in our nation were to desire a system that would restrict the religious liberty of others, then we would have to resist that. And we actually have means to resist that.
How does protecting the religious freedom of others guarantee our own religious freedoms?
For the next 20 years, probably one of the great struggles inside of our country, let alone around the world, be struggles of religious liberty. I want Christians to be the ones who are saying, no, religious liberty for me and religious liberty for all, it's the first freedom. It's that which everything else is built upon.
Well, Ed, you know scripture. Does the Bible teach us to respect and protect people of other faiths?
Everyone's made in the image of God, and the founders of our nation talked about inalienable rights that come from the Creator. Well, that comes from the fact that men and women are made in the image of God. And being made in the image of God, they can walk away from God or they can walk to another God, but they're made in the image of God and they have value and worth. And thus, we have to defend their value and worth and their freedom to make choices. God is a God who has allowed us to make choices.
Is this a problem of American Christianity as opposed to other countries? Are we too self-centered?
I do think that sometimes we cry persecution when really maybe in America we don't really know what persecution is for the vast majority of us. We need to stand up and say, no, religious liberty matters everywhere. And we need our leaders, we need our government to do so.
Ed Stetzer of Lifeway Research, thanks for your insights. Have a great day.
Supreme Court Justice Antonin Scalia says God has been good to the United States exactly because Americans have honored him. He also spoke out on the idea of government's role in religion in public life, saying there's nothing wrong with the idea of presidents and others invoking God in speeches. He said there's nothing in America's constitutional tradition that says government cannot favor religious expression in public life. Scalia spoke recently at a Catholic high school in Louisiana.
And this is interesting. The United Kingdom is setting out to teach that Britain is officially a Christian nation. The International Business Times reports the British Secretary of Education made the announcement. Non-faith schools must now tell students that British religious traditions are Christian when they teach about other religions. The new Department of Education guidelines state that schools will not be forced to give atheist worldviews equal time with Christianity.
And you can find daily reports of the church around the world. Simply go to our Christian World News website. Find it at cbnnews.com. We will be back right after this.
CBN presents The Transforming Word, a new DVD and audio CD set from Pat Robertson.
I've recorded verses from the Bible which speak of fear and speak of deliverance. I want every one of you to listen carefully to these verses, and I want you to be free from fear.
The Transforming Word will teach you biblical principles to overcome fear, show you how to have victory over anxiety, and discover how hearing and speaking the Scripture can bring peace to your life.
For God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. Perfect love casts out fear, for fear has torment, and God does not want any of you to live in torment.
The Transforming Word, Volume 2, Verses to Overcome Fear and Experience Peace. Available now.
Life. It's meant to be lived fully. Jesus said it. I came to give you life, life to the fullest. Life in your family, life in your finances, life in your body, mind, and spirit, life in your everyday. At CBN.com, we're taking what Jesus said seriously. We're here to help you discover life. Life. Live it fully. CBN.com.
When you give, smiles grow bigger. When you care, homes are happier. When you comfort, the hurt goes away. When we all come together to love, miracles happen.
And welcome back to the broadcast. A 3,400-year-old Canaanite citadel is being integrated with a part of a brand new high-rise apartment complex in northern Israel. Archaeologists with the Israel Antiquities Authority uncovered the ancient citadel in the seaside city of Nahariya recently. They say it was likely an administrative center that served mariners along the Mediterranean coast more than 3,000 years ago. Part of the citadel will be preserved and put on display in the basement of the new apartment building.
And finally this week, Superbook has reached a new milestone in India. Superbook was the official kids' animation partner at India's largest kids' carnival in New Delhi. The event drew thousands of parents and children from New Delhi and nearby states, introducing them to the animated series and sharing the message of salvation. Children got to sing, dance, play games, and meet Gizmo. A local newspaper also reported Gizmo's special appearance at the carnival. Wow. Gizmo gets around.
They all over the world. I mean, from the Philippines to parts of Africa. What a terrific ministry to introduce people to the gospel of Jesus Christ.
He might be getting almost as popular as like some of the Star Wars characters.
Yeah, let's hope so.
Yeah, let's hope so.
Let's hope so. Well, folks, that is it for this week's edition of Christian World News.
Until next week, from all of us here, goodbye and God bless you.